My father was diagnosed as manic depressive.
My mother suffered from deep, deep depression and alcoholism. My father suffered from terrible post-traumatic stress.
I struggled with the fear that one day I would have a mental illness. And my wife and I struggle with the fear that one day our kids will be facing these illnesses as well.
Though bipolar illness has a strong genetic component, it is often not discussed by relatives. But once someone is diagnosed as bipolar, quirky bends in the family tree take on new significance.
We have that uncle who never comes up the stairs, who is kind of hermit-like, but everybody just says, oh, that's just Uncle DJ, and everybody knows that Uncle DJ stays in it. Well, no, what's happening with Uncle DJ? Like, has anybody ever had a conversation with Uncle DJ? Has Uncle DJ ever been to a hospital?
I knew that my family runs rampant with mental illness, but I'm the only person diagnosed bipolar.
In the 1990s, back in the heady days of mapping the human genome, it was hoped that we would not only diagnose, but eradicate diseases like bipolar by finding a culprit gene and fixing it.
When I began my career, molecular genetics was just being developed as a method to map genes for illnesses, and it was a very exciting time.
This is John Kelso, a geneticist at UC San Diego.
Of all of the psychiatric illnesses at that time, bipolar disorder seemed to be the most genetic.
And this is his colleague, Melvin McInnes, at the University of Michigan.
Many of us started our career in the genetics of bipolar disorder, looking at identifying families with bipolar disorder and searching for genes that cause bipolar disorder.
If there were one gene for bipolar disorder, we would have it by now.
Scientists now believe many genes contribute to the onset of bipolar illness.
That's the big question, how many genes? It's certainly in the dozens, it may be in the hundreds, it might be in the thousands.
Having a list of genes is great, and it's a major advance, but that's a starting point.